I see a lot of patients who are concerned about their memory and don't have a diagnosis yet. I see patients with mild forms of cognitive impairment, and I also see patients with dementia, some more severe cognitive concerns, including patients with Alzheimer's disease, frontotemporal disease, other less common forms of dementia. You know, we all think of Alzheimer's as someone who's forgetful and has a lot of short-term memory loss. These patients come in and their initial and most prominent symptoms had to do with language processing or with visuospatial processing. So maybe they're having trouble finding the ketchup on a crowded shelf in the refrigerator, even though it's right in front of them. Or maybe it's hard for them to repeat back a phone number after someone gives it to them. There are also other forms of dementia that have nothing to do with Alzheimer's disease, some of which cause these same kinds of language predominant problems. So there are a lot of syndromes that also have movement issues associated with them. Is it memory that's the biggest problem? Is sleep involved? Are they having funny movements as well? All these things are sort of clues to me to figuring out where things are going. Just being able to walk through that process with that family, offering whatever resources and medications I can to make things better and to help the person feel better, that's also just such a valuable thing to be able to share with families.